Alright guys, so it's currently 9 o'clock at night and I'm back out in the garage. I took a small power nap after running from pawn store to pawn store with my girlfriend today. That was our date day. We went and hit up pawn stores and bought a bunch of random stuff. I've got some cool tools today though, which is good. Tonight is going to be a lot of work centered on this GTO here, my 68 GTO. You've seen this on the channel a bunch of times if you're new. It's got a turbo 5.3 in it and a turbo 400 that has come apart several times, so that is why I'm putting this one in it, which is basically as far as I'd like to get tonight, is getting this thing bolted up in there and maybe do the finish work tomorrow. This one is a reverse manual valve body with a trans brake. It was built by Transmissions to Go. It was originally for a 1400 horsepower Fox body. It will be just fine in my half that horsepower GTO, and I have a new converter. I have a really cool cooler set up that I'll show you here in a minute. I've got lots of stuff to stick this thing in this car and then hit the road. So that is the plan for tonight. This is my JEGS XHD torque converter. It has dual anti-ballooning plates, stuff like that. Specifically for blower, nitrous, and turbo applications, and they rate it to 800 horsepower. I have seen guys going 880s, low 9s, whatever, on this converter with this combo, and it has done just fine. I don't expect my car to even go 950s or 990s would be pretty awesome, but I don't imagine I'm gonna need to go much faster than that. So this should be perfectly fine for what I'm doing. In here, just some little finished up stuff. This is a crank hub spacer. These are my AN lines for my new cooler. And then this is, I can't remember how to say it, Durali. Anyway, it is a transmission cooler. It's this one. It has a fan with this bracket, and then the cooler has AN fittings coming off of it, and I will be sticking that under the car remotely, and I will be using this little thermostat here. If I can open it, I'll show you. In line, I have to convert this one to AN. I'll be using this in line, and it will kick the fan on at exactly 140 degrees for me so that I do not have to nanny that thing with a switch in the car. Also, pawn shop finds. I paid 50 bucks for this. Came with a 2 amp hour battery and a charger. And this is way better than the old one that I had. It is newer, and I believe the brushless motor is bigger than my other one. I also got this rigid chop saw, which I've wanted for a very long time. And it actually has a diamond blade on it down there that somebody has swapped on. This is like 180 new, and that blade can be anywhere from $60 to $100. And I paid 70 for this thing. So, pretty good. If you guys are ever looking for power tools or whatever, you can generally get pretty good deals on them at your local pawn shops. So, always worth checking them out.
Yeah, that's fun. It actually rides and drives nice.
I was driving this over the Mustang.
Yeah.
Like, it actually is...
It's comfortable.
Comfy, killer gas mileage. You would be astonished at the fuel mileage out of this thing.
Yeah, it's crazy that it can make 3 times the power of the Mustang, but get better mileage.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
3 times is... might be low.
Yeah, I think 3 times is...
Probably 4 or 5.
3 times is pretty low estimate.
You might be making that for the wheels. The C10, like, it's fast, but it's about equal to, like, a Coyote.
Uh-huh.
So it doesn't bother me as much, because we're not, like, going crazy fast.
Yeah.
But this thing is, you know. Like, I gotta be a little more respectful of what this one can do. I mean, it can go 0 to 140 in probably 9 seconds.
Even with the bad tranny, it was going like 40 to 130 faster than a GTR or a Viper and stuff.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what I mean.
Yeah.
Like, you gotta respect that a little more. That's not something that you fuck around on 2-lane roads in.
Yeah.
You know, racing cars that run 13s and 12s.
Yeah.
It's kind of, it's irresponsible.
I need something to tap these a little bit, because...
Oh, you're doing shit. What are you tapping?
The U-bolts. I just need a small hammer or something. They're just being a little tight. Or even a flat head screwdriver would help, but it doesn't matter. I'll just tap them. Okay. They probably just need a little bit of a... Yeah, that's all.
It's kind of weird right now. It's like spacey.
Yeah.
Probably, you said you did it the other day.
Yeah. Well, it's probably because you took a nap. It's in the light.
Oh, you're using it?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. That's a wonder. Well, I got the other ones charging.
Uh-huh.
And I was confused. I'm like, well, what?
All right. I'm gonna hand this out to you out that side, and then you can tape up the U-joints.
OP XH, like a heavy duty, XHD. It's a BOP heavy duty case.
Uh-huh.
But it's got a bolt-in yoke.
Doug used a leftover shaft.
Doug used the leftover output shaft is more likely. That's unconfirmed. I mean, they could have came with that. I don't know much about the HD BOP cases, but that looks like the guy just used a leftover shaft from a truck. Hey, you got the seal put in all the way on this one.
Oh, yeah.
That's good. That's progress. God. That guy sucks.
What's this over here? 916s?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, guys, on this one, the tranny crossmember is only held in with 4 bolts, whereas on the C10, there's a lower mount like this, but then there's another one that goes up to the top part of the frame, so you have double the bolts, you know?
Yeah, it's a stupid design. They didn't need to have any of that.
Not necessary, for sure.
There you go. Hi. It's 3:15
yep.
In the morning. Yeah, I'm having a good time. Anyway, that one's out. The B&M adapter to the BOP is out, and the crank hub adapter that was for that setup is out. I'm not going to explain to you what was involved in that. I've had a horrible night, though. It involved... Anyway, horrible night. It's out, though. It's over there. It's got stuff welded to it. It was a good time. I've ruined several tools. The good news is, now all I have to do is jack this up and stick this in. And now, it's just a Chevy bolt pattern to a Chevy bolt pattern. You're not going to see this on Vice Grip Garage. Oh God. Okay. Well, anyway, on with the show. We didn't film a lot of that. You wouldn't have wanted to see it. It just was a Jerry Springer episode down here for a couple hours there.
Yeah, we're kind of hoping that the crank's still fully in the motor and not, you know, pulled back a little bit.
Some stuff that happened and a lot of hammering and anyway. Yeah. Alright, let's get this in. There is a way. It's in all the way. Right. It doesn't do the 3 clunk, but it's like it's on the that's it hitting the plate. Thank you.
feels like it's all there now. That's the transmission cooler down there. We just heard it kick on after that long drive and some poles.
The cooling fan and the transmission has its own little thermostat, and I have the cooler wired off of the same excite wire that goes to my dual fans on my radiator. So whenever the switch is flipped for those, it can also turn the fan on, but it doesn't run constant because the thermostat that's wired in line, whenever it detects that the transmission fluid has reached, I think, 140 degrees, it kicks the cooling fan on its own. So I don't have to sit there and nanny it and pay attention to another gauge. So worked good.
Yeah, and it took, 20 miles of driving, a little bit around town, a couple little poles, and then finally it kicked on right here when it was sitting idling.
Yeah. It's pretty good.
Yeah.
Yeah, and we did one pull off camera.
Yeah.
Felt good. Pretty quick. Makes a lot of the other vehicles here feel very slow.
So this first drive was just a little test run, obviously being careful, going to double check the fluid, all that good stuff, and then we'll run a little harder in some future video.
Yeah. Plus it's time, everybody's home from work already and stuff. I don't want to be a complete ass. So, all right, we'll see you guys in the next one. Tranquil out here.